Gun and Pro Coffee. You find all of our content at rebelloveshow.com, and we are here live at the Radisson in Manchester, New Hampshire for Liberty Forum 2016.
For the live studio, I'm here to see Rebel.
Yes.
And I was so worried that you wouldn't even get here in time.
Babe,
you literally walked in like a diva, walking like all dressed up.
She was hanging out with Renee late.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't
believe it. It wasn't my fault this time. This time I rubbed off on Ellen's.
Well, actually, we all ended up being late because I lost the blood there. And it was
well, then, okay, all right. That's a reasonable excuse.
Yeah, this
you needed to smoke before you came.
Oh, but there's our guest of honor. So
MVG.
Thank you for coming on and filling in.
Mateus, come on next time. Don't worry about it for now. I want to talk about last night,
oh, yeah.
Here at Liberty Forum, Anarchy After Dark. Now, mind you, I did drop the producer role a little bit, but in all fairness, I didn't think you brought your A game. You somehow Renee pulled a miracle out of her ass and got Vermin Supreme to like co-host your show.
She's gonna like host her show.
That's what I do.
Vermin Supreme hosted her show.
I beat people. I procrastinate to no end. Like I always come in ready to fuck shit up and then poof, match
it. All just wants
to. I don't know how you do it. It seems like you do that every week.
It's
like every week, it's like sometimes it's a miracle that like it gets up, it's operational, everything's going, you know. Yeah, I was impressed. But Vermin Supreme was awesome last night.
Yeah,
that was
awesome.
That was
awesome. We were awesome. So thank us.
And
I had so many people on. I had you, I had Ron, I had Vermin, I had Allie Havens, I had Ellen Wall.
It was like
it
was also Seditious Sirens.
Yeah,
it was
a Seditious Sirens reunion.
Reunion with the Bumpers.
Reunion, it was around the Love Show reunion.
Wait, can I just say, so last night I made a joke on Anarchy After Dark, and Renee said, how do you see Liberty Forum ending? And I said, in flames, like as a joke. And then last night, we're leaving, we're all drunk and hot guys, sleeping out, and then all of a sudden, like, I smell smoke, like, and a bunch of police just like, just hurry in. And I'm like, oh my god, is this building on fire?
Yeah, so like we ended up doing a little bit of cop locking last night.
Yeah,
but,
we
now
we
you were bitching at me that we weren't there. We were cop locking before you. We were walking up and I saw you guys running out of the hotel.
Yeah, I didn't see you right away.
Yeah,
Rob came from further.
Rob was like, what's going on? Because there are cops over there. And he's like, I don't want to go close. And then he sees Ian walking up. And he's like, well, Ian's on the front line. Okay,
I wasn't following. I'm like,
get the fuck out there. God damn it. Porkfest, Liberty Forum, a huge amount of anarchists. But it's always Ian who's first on the fucking scene.
Well, that's because he's a hardcore. He's always going to be there. I would be shocked if he wasn't.
Yeah, he lives for that shit. He loves it.
Yeah. Though what's sad was that guy, he literally got chased down by like four cop cars. People are like running after him, and he's running from the state, and they capture him. And we're there just like seeing, making sure that you know he's not being harmed by the police.
Yeah. So let me clarify. It wasn't a fire. It was some guy running from the cops, and there were like six cop cars, and they all got out and beat the shit out of him.
Oh, they didn't beat the shit out of them.
That's what they said.
Yeah.
When they all got there, they were like beating him up and he said it. Because they were like, well, he ran, so we got to kick your ass, I guess, is what they said. And then they had him on the ground on his knees, and then we're over there cop locking. And then Ian's like chanting, let him go. And then he goes, I don't want to go. They should arrest me. I didn't do what I was told.
Like this guy's literally being kidnapped, and he's like, "No, they're supposed to be doing this. They're supposed to be roughing me up and kidnapping me. That's why I was running. But
yeah.
Like, I deserve it because I ran."
He said they're just doing their jobs, and I was like, "Is this like are we the time?
Like, yeah, it's like why even bother? Like, all right, let them do. I don't even want to record this. I don't even want to put the video up because this guy doesn't even deserve that much. That like here we are like risking our lives, not our lives, but like we're risking being arrested. Like people get arrested for filming cops in this country, and here we are trying to help this guy, just help him out, and he'd rather have be kidnapped and whatnot. It was shocking.
It's because he's a sheep, you know. Sheep can't be like some people are just too far in. Like they kick this guy's ass, and he's still like, no, they're state's gonna stay.
Yeah, no, exactly. At least luckily around, you know, for the most part, we're lucky that we live here in Manchester where there's, you know, hundreds and hundreds of us that all
Yeah.
You know.
But what was rude about the cops, most and foremost? Like, they kick this guy's ass, and, like, they're making all this disturbance, like, in front of the hotel, and we're, like, asking them questions. Like, hold yourself accountable. Like, we're having a conference here, and you're ruining our conference, like, with all your flashing lights and fucking tires squealing. And they wouldn't say anything. They didn't open their mouth to say anything to us. They wouldn't say why they were here. They wouldn't say where they were coming from.
And they were laughing about what they were doing.
Like, yeah, they beat them up. They're like, can you speak for yourself? Why do you have to, like, be rough with this guy? And they just wouldn't say anything. It's like they didn't owe us, like, an explanation, but you do. And, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm pretty sure we pay your salary, and they're not above the law. So if you ask them what they're doing here, causing a ruckus, like, they're supposed to answer to that. So the guy was a dick, but the police were even more of a dick.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, the police definitely were, but it's just sad to see that, you know, he went along with it. But most cops get off on, like, they love to hunt. They love it seems like when they're, if someone runs, that's when they get excited.
Yeah.
That's when they're, like, that's when they're,
when
that,
someone runs,
it's
they're,
like,
they're happy because they get to kick their ass and they know it for a little while.
Like, for me, like, I do sales, so, like, when someone says no, that's when the sale starts, and that's when I get excited. With, you know, they're not saying no to me, I'm going to turn it around. But for me, I'm just selling. For them, it's like, it's the hunt. When it actually starts, that's when they're happy.
Yeah.
It's sad to see that sometimes. It's, like, horrible to see police really do that. But besides that, Renee, how's your Liberty Forum been so far?
She came
for
one day.
I just got my
badge.
Like,
you just got it.
Yeah.
So
I missed Edward Snowden.
Both of you missed Edward Snowden. I'll be talking about it later today.
Before Edward Snowden.
It was a packed house. Like it was crazy to see that many people in there. Like there's only a couple times where you see like so many Free Staters all in the same like group shot. That's usually just at Pork Fest. And literally the entire auditorium hall was just filled. Like there's standing room only in the back, telling people were.
I'm sad I missed it. But like it was like 8 o'clock this morning. We were dressed in like 2 seconds.
I'm
like
partying all night.
Yeah, and I'm like, I can't just do that. I don't wake up like this. Like I know I don't really believe so.
It takes work.
Yeah. And he didn't even speak till 11. So you know,
yeah, and he didn't even make you literally walked in the door literally 5 minutes before the show starts.
Yeah.
Which is 2 o'clock.
So, what are some highlights? You have to fill us in.
On the Edward Snowden
highlights?
Yeah,
they
brought up, it was a bunch of stuff. First off, Nick Lepsi of Reason was moderating it, which was pretty cool. I'm a fan of his. He brought up kind of about secession a little bit, but it was supposed to be a question, and he kind of like worded it to where it was more of like a statement that there's people here that believe in independence, but like he was supposed to really ask that as a question to Edward Snowden, and that didn't happen. But that's not, it's sad that didn't happen, but the fact that they were talking about that just was good enough for me. He talked about a lot of privacy issues. There were a lot of funny moments. They asked him if, is it even possible for him to vote? Is he going to actually vote, which is hilarious.
Just send in his ballot.
Yeah.
He could do that. Well, thank you, Renee, for coming on.
No props. Fuck you guys enough.
Peace, Renee. So go check out Anarchy After Dark. I'm sure there's something online, maybe a website someday.
It'll be out there.
Or a podcast.
Renee,
wait,
do you
have anything?
Get right on.
Bye, bitch.
Peace the fuck out.
This is Gerard.
All right, Mateus.
Daily precious metals update. On Friday, gold is down $1 to $1,241 per ounce. Silver is down about $15.43 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $420 US dollars. Friday's round is $1,000. If all your investments are paper promises, we should probably talk. Give us a call at 800-874-9760.
Oh, yeah. That has to be done. Well. But after this, the only thing I gotta do is rub the table for a little bit. I can talk to people high while I'm over it. I have like little responsibility after the show, so I've been working like the last 2 days. I've been running around like tonight. I'm partying hard.
when you have a January 2016,
oh, I love, we're literally passing around the vape pens left and right and stuff like that. Oh, yeah, we got you. Yeah, we always have pictures. We need a picture with each guest. Each guest we have on. Picture shot. Alright, bring it back. Then after this segment,
the three most important things you can do for LRM.
I'm gonna try and see your talk at five.
Let your friends know.
No, four. Yeah, we're out of four, so I'm gonna try and pack up what I can. I may miss some of it because I gotta see it packed up. Where is it?
Amazon is the largest online retailer.
I may just walk over there and then come back and grab this stuff.
Please do your online shopping at shop.lrn.fm. Now that multiple times you do the high school sources have confirmed that Junior Jesse and all my son are speculating that you'll go all the way with your boyfriend Josh Gibson as early as this Friday.
I have like 50 some more plus pictures I need to post. I'm hoping Tatiana has their cable hooked up.
Now that your news is settling in,
he might. If not, we'll just put the mic next to it. It's not that big of a deal. The mic will still take it. So.
Keep checking theonion.com for more news as this story progresses. Did you know you can get news updates about what's happening?
We come back at.
You prefer?
Yes.
You can sign up for our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. Plus, you can stay in the loop by joining our Facebook profile at facebook.lrn.fm or follow us at Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm. It's all free, so sign up now at updates.lrn.fm for news updates delivered to your email box, facebook.lrn.fm to follow our Facebook page, and twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets.
If you want to move to free state, and you're looking for some real estate,
I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you?
You know what, you need to start doing more commercials for LRN. You need to be like the voice star of LRN, like the up and coming, the rising star. You need to do like other commercials on LRN.
Or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
What's up next?
Right after this.
Delivery Radio Network program guide. Find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. It's your Rebel Mistress here with Mom and I.
Oh.
Our frequent recurring guest, Matthias Bond.
Serial guest.
Serial guest.
I don't think you're on number 10.
M-B-G.
I lost count.
You lost track? Totally. So we decided that. As a serial guest, we hold you in very high regard.
And best guest we've had.
You're the best guest
fantastic.
We've had.
Wow.
So we wanted to celebrate that. Got you a gift.
Oh, my goodness.
The disappearing civil liberties mug.
Pour a coffee in there. It all disappears.
Wow, this is really cool.
So yeah, that's your pro pocket. I mean, your pro coffee gift. You stay on another 10.
And maybe we'll smoke you up.
It will be, if you're
We're
going
to
program
you
at some point.
It's okay.
You know what? Maybe if you're on like show 100 or something, we'll buy you a gun.
We'll see. Okay, how's your Liberty Forum been?
Honestly, I haven't had too much of it. I've only been here for a few talks and a few, kind of wandering around tables, seeing who's presenting, who's got new material. But it hasn't really been like all day, every day Liberty Forum for me.
Did you make it to Edward Snowden?
I did not. Hey, it was way too early.
I know. It was 11 a.m. is pretty early. Yeah, that's true.
From last night, I was not about to get up anything before noon.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
So it was unfortunate. You know, if it was like tonight. I would love to go, and I make an effort to go. But
they should have had it at like 7 o'clock or something.
Anything requires me to set an alarm clock during events like Liberty Forum or like Porkfest, whatever. It's anything. It's like at 8 a.m.
Anything before noon, especially at Porkfest. Anything before noon. That's like the worst time slot you can possibly have. Is like the beyond the morning Porkfest, especially later on in the
morning show.
Everyone's fatigued.
Yeah,
because
you're partying every night.
You're
partying every night. So it's like, what? I'm not going to get up at 9 a.m. to go see something in a tent. It's like, no, I'm going to be sleeping in. The best time slots in the conferences, especially Porkfest, is like that 2 to 5 time slot.
Yeah.
Like that time, that's when everyone's kind of, their lunches, their breakfast, are getting out, they're like moving around. Like that's finally when you're, like, you're ready to go. Like 2 early in the morning.
Yeah.
11 a.m. wasn't that early, though.
Didn't you give 2 talks yesterday?
I did, actually.
So what was the first one?
The first talk that I gave was on darknet marketplaces. So talking about the Silk Road, talking about Open Bazaar, talking about the kind of technology that allowed us to have real true free trade over the internet, you know, with things like Bitcoin, right, things like Tor. So it's really exciting kind of from an economic perspective and from like a libertarian perspective. This is the biggest middle finger to the state, you know, that we're all like trading, we're all in the agents that they're not a part of. And the second talk I gave was on anti-politics. And I did that for the alt-expo people. And they're, you know, happy to have me, I guess, recurring speaker as well. But it was my usual, you know, perspective with the new ideas thrown in.
Yeah,
and
you
how I feel about voting and so forth.
Yeah, what's your, you have a talk right after the Rebel Love Show here. What's it going
to
be on?
Yeah, so 4 o'clock, I'm talking about Bitcoin. I'm going to try to make it a one part educational, one part current events type of talk for people to jump in and kind of hear about not only how Bitcoin works and why it's important. I think a lot of us know that.
You know, one thing I love about these conferences
where
is that. Like you get so many people that come in that they're Bitcoin newbies. So like everyone here in the Shire are like Bitcoin experts or at least users. Like we all have, you know, like a Mycelium wallet or something along those lines on your smartphone. Everyone uses it, and not day to day, but we use it often. And I had multiple conversations earlier today because I've been manning the Foundation for National Independence booth down in the vendor area. So if you're still here, go check it out and go to nhindependence.org. I had multiple conversations with both vendors and people here for the conference where vendors told me, yeah, like, Herschel's like, I've sold almost everything I've done, like 70% has been Bitcoin, and half of them in Bitcoin transactions, like virgin transactions that people did for the first time, buying something in person. I had another conversation with people that are moving in like a year, they're like, she was saying, I don't know what Bitcoin wallet to use. I'm like, what wallet to use? Like, I'm using this on like a daily basis. So I just take out my Mycelium wallet. I'm like, here's the transactions. I'm just like, I'm still scrolling. Still scrolling. These are like almost all these are in-person transactions.
Right, yeah.
You know?
I went to Daily Decrypt the other day and I got interviewed about like my use of Bitcoin. And they wanted to know how frequent I use it. And I think I use it at least like on a regular enough basis where I like to keep my wallet, you know, handy. I use it at Community Market Day, and I always try to buy something community oriented so I can support like the agorist vendors. And then just person-to-person transactions are just so frequent. Like, I pay my rent in Bitcoin, and that amazes most people when they're like, oh, yeah, we pay our rent in Bitcoin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's, like, for us, like, paying rent in Bitcoin, that sounds bizarre, but, like, that's a normal thing for a lot of porks in Manchester, like, paying rent with Bitcoin. Like, it's, like, a normal occurrence.
It pisses you off when people say, you know, Bitcoin isn't money, because I was, like, trying to get one of my persons who handles drugs and gives it to me for currency.
Yeah, you're not a good drug dealer. You're not a good drug dealer if you don't accept Bitcoin.
Yeah,
yeah,
I was trying to give him to
like,
me that, and he was like, oh no, like, I'd rather it's a Facebook pay. And I was like, cause it all came up because the bank called me because they closed my card. They were like, oh, you said someone
some if money over Facebook.
Oh, no, but listen, they named the person, like, first and last name. You sent this person money, like, this amount of money at this time and everything. And I was like, what the fuck? And I was like, yeah, that was me. But they were, like, trying to make sure it wasn't fraud. I was like, yeah, that was me. But the fact that they can say your first, last name and what time they put it on there makes me not want to pay you through Facebook pay for drugs. And, like, I told him, I was like, you should stop, like, doing that. And he was like, oh, well, I'm not going to stop because they just want to make sure it's not fraud. But I'm like, you're okay as a bank? And he's, like, supposedly... I don't know if he's an anarchist, but he's a libertarian. He's in our circle. And
I'm like,
how is that okay with you? Like, I really don't understand how anyone would want, like, their information out there just like that. Like, I don't want the bank to have all my information and know your first and last name.
I think once you start tasting a little bit of financial privacy, then you don't want to give it up again.
Yeah.
You don't want to start using Bitcoin just a little bit.
Well, I mean, especially
when you're doing... Like, you won't take Bitcoin, because it's not real money.
I mean, especially considering New Hampshire, you know, selling pot is illegal, so it's like, you're breaking the law anyways, why would you want to, like, have a paper trail?
Right, exactly.
Like,
that's not legal anywhere.
Well, I mean, you can sell in, there's states that it's legal to sell pot, but other drugs.
Not just on the street.
Well, yeah, you need a license or something, but even then, like, agorism, like, it's just, you know, you need to be an agorist.
Yeah. But, I mean, I feel like I warned him, and he was just so ignorant about it that I couldn't even say anything. Like, most times I feel like I want to talk people into it and, like, say reasonable things. But after, you know, I said, you know, your privacy has been violated, and he didn't even care, like, that just makes me want to be like, okay, fuck you.
Well, it's like, it's like the guy last night. It's, you know, don't let me go.
Don't let me go.
We're trying to help you, but...
Yeah, if you don't want to help, you can't help
anyone.
The only thing we can do is just... You know, lead by example, and hopefully more people will follow through with us. Thanks for coming on, Mateus.
Thank you for having me on here.
Hopefully, where can everyone find you at online? I say this every time.
Well,
can't
find
you. Well, enjoy your run. We love
you. Appreciate
you.
It.
All right, let's smoke up later. I'm gonna fix this. What did I do?
Just go to South Park, right? It's crazy to get the license to. For a recreational license, you have to have a medical license first. You have to convert your medical license to a recreational license.
Thank you. Thank you. Coming back in 2 minutes. You want to sit right there? You sit right there. Don't. It don't matter to us. No. Actually, sit there. Way the camera angle is. Be right there. No. Right there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Imagine suddenly getting in your car, turning on the radio, and hearing the Liberty Radio Network. You can make that vision a reality with your own micro radio station. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how you can put our programs on the air in your area. You can have lrn.fm right around the clock, and you can even add in your own local shows. Building your radio station is simple, but programming isn't. That's where lrn.fm comes in. Learn more at broadcast.lrn.fm. That's broadcast.lrn.fm.
So yeah, I figured I'd talk about, because I'm on count for 2 seconds, if that's cool, so until 3 o'clock. I kind of want to talk, obviously, for cell 411, why you made it, all that jazz. I'm sure you can go on for, like, lengths about it. Is your puppy. Yeah, I know you do a lot of cop blocking and whatnot, so I kind of want to talk about how you got into that, why you do it, any stories, crazy stories, whatnot. And then also, again, Tara McKenna, you know, psychonaut journeys, because I had a bad mushroom trip, and I wanted to, not bad, it was I had a bad trip, I'm saying I had a bad, every time I take it, like, it's not,
so I do more than
Okay. Well, see this, too, because we're going to repeat this out there. I'm going to say, like, you know, what I want to talk about next. Oh, also, is there anything off the table?
Okay, cool.
I say, no, you're a first time guest.
I'm not going to do that.
Are you going to still?
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, live here at Liberty Forum in the Radisson Hotel in Manchester, New Hampshire, for the Free States Project. Free State. And we got Virgil here. How do you pronounce your last name, Virgil?
Baduva.
Virgil
Baduva.
Yes.
All right. And you're living in, you're normally in Ohio? Is that where
you're? Yeah, we live in Ohio. I'm originally from Romania, actually. So I've been here for about 20-some years, something like that.
I just audio narrated a book about a girl who lives in Bucharest, Romania.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I grew up about, I don't know, an hour or so south of Bucharest.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. So, Virgil, you're the man behind Cell 411. What exactly is that? Why should I have this on my device?
Wait, can I ask you a question first? Because I don't know you. So I know everyone else is, but like, what do you? How long have you been in the Liberty Movement? Aren't you famous for, like, taking photos of people now?
I am.
Yeah, you are a great photographer. I had you took a photo of me last year, actually, in this room. I was with Davi. No, not this room, downstairs. I had that as, like, my profile picture for, like,
cool.
6 months.
Yeah, see, that makes me happy. Whenever people use my pictures, that's great. I don't know if I'm famous, but, you know, I go around, take pictures of people, make them happy. That makes me happy.
Now, how long have you been a part of the Liberty?
Good question. So I got into this probably about 7, 8 years or so ago. I can't remember exactly. I ran across a video of Damo and Pete cop blocking in Ohio. And that's when I got into open carry. So I kind of tangentially ended up in the Liberty Movement because I was into firearms.
Oh, okay.
And then I heard the cop block, and then I started reading more, and then I came across Free Talk Live. And then I got hooked on Free Talk Live, and here I am, crazy.
But you haven't moved yet.
No, we haven't moved, and we will probably be late movers.
Did you sign the intent?
I did, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Beautiful. Well, don't, from living here. Just,
I did, my wife didn't.
You can still sign, apparently. They still take signers. It doesn't really mean anything anymore, but
well,
you could still sign if you wanted to.
Right.
But my advice, don't wait. I've been here 2 years.
The problem is the job market in New Hampshire.
Wait, what do you do besides cell phone?
I do a very niche. I do security work, right? Like,
okay.
Information security is really tough. Unless you want to work in Boston or New York City, it's hard to find jobs like that here.
Well, you know,
so,
Manchester is only about an hour drive away from Boston.
I know.
It's only an hour commute. It's not that far.
But is there a big Liberty scene in Ohio?
Actually, it wasn't a few years ago. Now we have probably, I would say, 70 volunteers in our area.
Okay.
It kind of started with cop blocking, and, you know, before you know it, we have a ton of people showing up, and they all claim to be libertarians and volunteers, which is great, but it's not New Hampshire, so.
Yeah. No, I think it's great, but spread liberty wherever you are until you're ready to move, and then, you know.
Yeah,
right.
It's well worth it. Like when you go to Porkfest, you know how like you love Porkfest.
Oh, I know.
We come home to Porkfest. We leave Porkfest and we just
It's like going to Park Fest is just like a little bit more higher up. Like, all right, cool. Like, everyone's here. It's like a family, like internet family reunion, but we come back to like the same group of people.
Yeah, we were there for the last couple of years and we love Park Fest. I mean, we have four kids, you know, they love it.
Oh, wow.
How can you go wrong with Park Fest in any way? I mean, unless you maybe overdo something. Yeah.
Well, just do just enough and a little bit more after that.
So Cell 411, you created, I know there was a kind of a similar app before that. I don't know if you were behind
what
that.
What exactly is Cell 411?
Yeah, so there was used to be an app called Peacekeeper, right? And I didn't know about Peacekeeper until 6 months or so ago. And then Orkfest, while you know, I was telling the guys from Free Talk Live a couple of days ago, while I was on some under the influence of some things, you know, I've interacted with some folks, and then Joel Valenzuela actually showed me an app he was working on. It was pretty shitty, but, you know, he had good intentions. And Joel, by the way, loves it, you know, loves Cell 411. And I kind of took his idea and modeled it into something better. And that's kind of how this app came about. And Peacekeeper had great intentions, except it sounds like the app never really worked. Right?
What does it do? Like, what does that?
Yeah, so basically it's an app that allows you, you put it on your smartphone, and it allows you to issue emergency alerts and kind of, you know, attempt to get rid of police and other government services. That's really the ultimate goal. And what it does is you pop up the app, you know, you tap a couple of buttons, and you can issue any sort of alerts. If you're arrested, you get pulled over, you have a flat tire, you have a medical problem, and you create these cells or groups, small groups of friends, or they don't have to be small, actually, they can be large. And they get a notification about, you know, what the problem is. They get the exact GPS coordinates with your location and turn-by-turn directions on how to get to you if they want to come and help you. So it's this idea that, you know, people should be able to help each other on a voluntary basis without using the state.
That's in the App Store? Do you have to pay for this app?
No, in the beginning, I actually wanted to charge 99 cents for it, but it turned out that people don't want to pay anything for any apps, so
ever.
Yeah.
Ever, right?
Yeah.
So we have made it free, you know, ate all the, you know, expenses associated with development and all that.
Did you code it yourself?
I didn't, man. I can write code. You probably don't want me to write code, and we end up getting really poor quality code, but I have a great team of developers that I work with, and they're pretty good guys.
How long did it take to develop? Yeah.
So version one, we turned it around in a couple of months. It was really crappy, just like anything that, you know, incremental, you know, improvements, but version 2.2 came out the night before Liberty Forum started, and it's fantastic. So I feel really good about version 2.2. It's mature. We got most of the features under control, and we actually introduced public cells, which is the idea that we can create public groups. You don't have to know the people, everyone involved in it. People can just kind of, like Facebook groups, right? People can join. You don't have to know them all, but you can all kind of share alerts and information with each other. So it looks like it's picking up big time.
So, did you specifically design this with like the Liberty community in mind?
Of course.
We're all so close knit. But I feel like maybe even like Muggles, I don't want to call them Muggles, non-Liberty people could also use this app. So maybe
they
people,
are.
Oh, they are.
Yeah, there are people all over the world.
You should sell some
that.
Advertisement on it. They can make some money.
I don't know. I'm trying to stay away from that, but we're still trying to find ways to make money. And
yeah.
In version 3, we're going to introduce first responder payments. So if you get a flat tire on the side of the road, you can actually put a bid out for anyone willing to come and help you. And if someone sees, hey, Virgil needs help because he has a flat tire, doesn't know how to change it, he's offering $20 to anyone coming to help them, maybe
yeah.
Someone will be motivated by $20
yes.
And showing up to help.
That
them,
sounds
so.
Awesome. I have a friend that name gets stuck everywhere. It's like flat tires, ran out of gas on the expressway. Like, if she could have an app where she can call somebody else to help her.
Well, I would like
no,
to.
No, if that was the case, that app would just be, the notifications would just be going off the whole time.
Just
don't
off.
Get, don't give an A on that app.
Yeah, I would like to think in a voluntary society, that's kind of how the market of emergency response would work, you know? So.
In Ohio, you say you do cop blocking. Have you guys utilized for Cell 411?
Oh, we use it all the time. Yeah, we use it all the time, and it's been it's been only around for about 6 months technically. So we've got. I was looking at the database just last night. We had about 18,000 alerts that went out in the last 6 months. So in my mind, that's 18,000 instances of cops not being called on someone else. To me, that's huge, right?
Oh,
the,
yeah,
the less
yeah.
you have to interact with police and government employees,
yeah.
the better off.
Maybe they'll become obsolete or something.
Right, right. So that's a goal, really. I mean, the goal is let's subvert the state as much as possible. Get rid of police, and find a way to to help each other.
This is allowing like a decentralized way that have first responders. Where if you're in trouble, it doesn't have to be for cops pull you. There's multiple types of alerts you can do on the app. So.
And yesterday I did a session at 4 o'clock with a few folks on how to use the app, and we ran across we did some brainstorming as to how we can improve it, and we talked a lot about medical emergencies and how in a voluntary society we would handle medical emergencies, and we got some really good ideas out of it.
Yeah.
Like EMTs registering with us with their exact location, so that way if someone needs help within a 5 mile radius, there's a certified EMT right there down the street, and they can show up and help them.
Have you ever considered like marketing self for one to emergency services people?
Actually, that's a good point. Yes, I want to partner up with police, with cops. Believe it or not, in a one-way type of scenario where if you have like a road closure or something happens in your town, you get an alert and avoid that area. So.
All right, we're coming up break. Mar with Virgil. We come back here at Liberty Forum in Manchester. Awesome. Yeah, I love Peacekeepers. I've been following like your posts about it and stuff like that. What? It's not in the store anymore. Why not? I downloaded it like a few days ago. No, not Peacekeeper. I'm sorry, Cell 411. Not Peacekeeper. My apologies. I said the wrong thing. Yeah, I'm not talking about Peacekeeper. I meant Cell 411. Yeah, she does voice acting. So.
One invitee, a pal, is a retired shot last close chicken, but I really like seeing the responses.
What? You need this. For sure. I love this kind of thing. You know what's fascinating, Virgil? You have a very similar entrance story as Renee does. Because like Renee was introduced to this by my phone. Can you take a picture like this? Oh, let me fix the banner. Hold on. Why is it keep falling?
There's also this
other
thing.
Yeah, take a picture of this.
It's my firm belief the AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar on an indie-oriented purse. Support all your favorite organizations, but make sure you buy the AMP program AMP.org.
Free Talk Live.
When you call the government bureaucracy, more often than not, the person who you talk to will tell you the answer to your question, or they'll tell you they think they know who this person is and have the answer they can answer. She just wants to play solitaire, and you interrupted her game, or she just wants to surf on the internet, and you just ruined her day.
Got it? Take, if you can, during the show, can you take a couple with that? Thank you.
Lorenzo FM is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices.
I always love, listening to LRN so much, I can tell which commercials you recorded when you were pissed off and which ones you didn't.
No, Anna will argue that, like, every time. He'll be like,
And he actually like edited up all the times I called him an asshole during like one recording, and it was pretty great.
I love my magic mug. I drink a lot of coffee. I have stains on my teeth. Then I found.
Does Mark really use my magic mug?
So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder. And the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin, mymagicmud.com.
I do want to come on to the site on that stuff.
You can watch the LRN Studio channel.
Sure, yeah, yeah.
LRN.FM.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, live at Liberty Forum 2016. We're here with Virgil V. Virgil Lee, that sounds stylish. And he was telling us about self-promotion. So I just have one last question about that, because I don't want to go into some psychonaut stuff. I love that shit. how easy is the setup for this app? Because I am the type of person, you almost convinced me to set it up, but just almost. Because it seemed like I had to do some extra things when I got in there, and that might be complicated for me. I'm like the rest of society. I like dumb, down
apps. Unless you're Mark Edge, you should be okay and should be able to use the app. Because Mark is the only guy I've met who actually doesn't understand how to use it. But again, Ian says he can't even program a VCR, so I don't know. But it's very easy. You just literally tap on one icon, a menu pops up, you hit a couple other buttons, and you're
done.
But
it's on the App Store.
It's in the App Store. Go to the Google Play Store, search for Cell411, Apple App Store, same thing. And you can just download it, install it, create an account. That's really probably the most painful process, create an account, and it should be good.
Not too bad. Okay, you convinced me.
All right.
Everyone,
go download Cell411.
Yes, by the way, I have t-shirts for you guys.
So, awesome.
There you go. Feel free to wear them.
I definitely will.
Okay, so enjoy.
Awesome. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, so I've been following your posts on Facebook, and I do love your posts.
Which ones? That's scary.
I follow all of them. All
right.
All right, and you've been talking about... You had a post about Terrence McKenna and how he like changed your life and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So obviously you're a fellow psychonaut. For me, we've been chronologically, not chronologically, we've been keeping track of like our trips, like going down this, like, you know, what works, what doesn't, how we feel just during the show. And I've never had like that great mushroom trip.
I've
had some
good
experiences.
I started microdosing.
Really?
And it was pretty awesome. But mushrooms are gross. I mean, everything
smells
like deep back there.
So I'll tell you guys, I'm really not as much into psychedelics as much. Well, not as much as I maybe post about it in public, but my first mushroom trip was really Orphis last year. Talking 7 months ago, however long it's been. And I would characterize it, I don't know how else to really describe it other than it was probably one of the most profound spiritual experiences I've ever had. And I was not expecting that. I was just expecting a high, and just messing around with Orpheus, and it became this huge, literally life-changing experience.
Yeah.
And I don't know why that is. I don't know why that happens for some people and doesn't for others.
Mushrooms are no joke.
Well, I do think with Porkfest, like the energy of everyone there definitely like adds to like going on a trip. Like we both did shrooms that day on Wednesday night.
It was Wednesday. I did have
yours was
more
than mine.
Like I hate people, so I did Molly and mushrooms. Yeah.
Both.
I ended up like crying for like 8 hours.
That's what I did
straight.
For the last couple of hours of my trip. I ended up
the whole time. I was happy, but it was unbelievable. But at first it was bad because there was a dark cloud that I saw that wasn't there, whatever.
Right.
But it was there, and I felt like it was going to kill us, and I felt like it was going to swoop up and murder us at any moment. It just has to get away. And it was like this contrast of good and bad, and it was like I was having to outrun like bad thing. But it really did change like my perspective on things after. I felt like after I was done crying, after I cried all the tears and the cloud went away, I felt like I peaked it. I peaked like that cloud and I can be a new person and I can be better. And I don't know if it was Porkfest, I don't know if it was everyone's energy, but I felt like it was so symbolic of like everything. Like, there may be bad things, but there's so much more to look forward to. And so skipping to that and ignoring the cloud in a whole way.
Yep. I think the setting is really, really important because I was walking around high at Porkfest and then I ran into this guy and he just gave me a hug. Right, and that just simple hug just completely shifts your mind into just a totally different, you know, space and time, if you will, in such a way that, you know, it just changes your perspective. Just very simple interactions like that can completely flip your mind around and maybe take you from a negative mindset to a very positive one, right? So, and then related to terrorism, again, I'm sorry, you know, DMT has been a huge experience for me as well prior to work.
How often have you done DMT?
I'm not going to talk about that. Come on, but it's enough times to kind of, you know, consider myself a educated user, right?
I feel like that's hard to find. Like, who just has that? Like, I don't know.
Yeah,
it's a little bit harder to find than others.
It is, and it's the reason DMT is great is because it's a very short trip, and if you're having a bad trip, you're not stuck in it for like 6 hours.
Have you seen Enter the Void?
I have not.
You need to watch that. That's like great. I've never done DMT, but it's like that's the experience on DMT. Like I didn't want to try it.
Yeah, but that's more of a bad trip than a.
No, it was a bad trip, but it was still intense.
There's a great book called The Spirit Molecule, and Joe Rogan actually did a documentary titled the same. It's on Netflix for free, guys. So I highly recommend you watch it. Fantastic.
Yeah, I've seen parts of it.
The Spirit Molecule.
The Spirit Molecule.
So what got you into into all that to begin with? What made you go down that rabbit hole?
Well, it was kind of Terrence McKenna, and then I started, you know, listening to Free Talk Live. These guys started talking about DMT one day, and I started reading about it. And then you kind of start go down the rabbit hole because your mind takes you to different places, makes you wonder, you know, what else can I explore? Because we're explorers, and your mind is really the biggest place you can explore.
Jason
Silva, have you ever seen him?
Yes.
Yeah.
You've gone down, it seems like you've gone down multiple rabbit holes.
Yeah.
All right. Seriously, like a lot of us, right. All of us, like we find something, we keep going down.
Yes.
What's the next rabbit hole you want to go down?
Oh man, that's a tough one. I don't know. I mean, MDMA is considered a mild psychedelic technically.
Have you done it or you want to?
Well, of course.
Okay.
How could you not?
The first time we did MDMA, technically she hippie flipped that time, but
right.
My first time doing MDMA, and same thing with my role mistress here, was the big gay dance party at Porkfest. I couldn't think of a better time to like roll. Like if I'm gonna roll, I'm gonna roll it right. I saved.
Nice.
I had it. I literally bought it in advance. Like,
like
6 months prior to like when I knew it's not something I can find.
It's hard to find.
Yeah. So when I found it, I'm like, all right, I know I want to do this, but I'm gonna be strong. I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna save for the right moment. Like I could.
That was your first time.
That was my first time.
So I did it in a completely different setting the first time. I was very cautious. I spent like months reading about it, and I somehow got around to it. I'm a kind of freak like that. I want to know. I'm a geek about it.
I want to know
how this works and why. And then I did it by myself. I didn't know what to expect. You know, my wife was at home kind of babysitting me, which is crazy. Think about someone kind of watching you, and that's crazy. Nothing bad can really happen. And I was by myself, and I remember listening to Pearl Jam or Pink Floyd. I don't remember who I had on listening to. And I remember feeling the music in my body and your fingertips. You can almost feel the music with your fingers and just absorb all this energy. And your mind is blown. You know, it's
oh
like,
yeah,
it's
yeah. You can feel energy from other people. You can feel music.
The only thing I don't like about MDMA, because I do like it. I like it. Don't get me wrong.
So here's how you deal with that. There's a substance called 5-HTP. It's available in any vitamin store or high-end vitamin stores. And what it is a precursor to serotonin. And it's basically tryptophan. So you guys heard of tryptophan?
Yeah.
Supposedly it's in turkey, but it's actually whole meats. And your body actually turns 5-HTP into serotonin. So before an MDMA trip and after, you're really good. It'd be very wise to just take a couple of 5-HTP pills, and you'll feel much better.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I definitely like to try that.
I don't like
any drug where I feel like I can't like bounce back.
Yeah.
I don't even like alcohol. That's why I don't even really drink. Like I'll
right.
have one beer because I don't like to be drunk. I don't like to throw up. I don't like to feel sick.
No, that's And yeah, 5-HTP, look it up. It's available in most vitamin stores. It really helps. It makes a big difference.
And then the other thing about Nuvia is sometimes people just are tweaking forever. I know a girl who's just like on a constant trip, but she just keeps taking it and keeps taking it.
That's so much
and
money.
She just like, yeah, it's a lot of money. And she's just like, but you can do like little bits, but she just like shakes constantly. And I'm like, I can't make it good. Don't get me wrong, but sometimes.
You can overdo it.
Yeah, I would want to like feel that way 24 hours a day. I feel like it's just like,
well,
over it.
Well, not only that, but you can in fact get brain damage if you overuse it, because what happens is when MDMA is broken down in your brain and serotonin is broken down, you end up with hydrogen peroxide, and it's basically a bypass product, which can actually fry your axons in your brain, literally.
Wow.
So you kind of get when they're saying that MDMA can cause brain damage, well, not
okay,
really,
cool.
But indirectly can actually get, you can get some problems. It's, you want to moderate.
Like, I feel like the vitamins, like he mentioned.
Yeah, I save it for special occasions. Like, I don't.
Right,
it's not something you want to do every time.
And it loses this magic over time.
Aaron, it's a really quick version. Where can everyone find you?
What's that?
Where can everyone find you at?
VirtualVeduca.com.
All right, go check it out, guys. Go download Cell 411.
Thanks,
we're coming back here live at Liberty Forum.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Oh, a pleasure, man. Absolute pleasure. Thank you. Yes, absolutely.
Cool. I'm bringing the scotch and everything.
All right, beautiful. All right.
It wasn't the best, on the camera, I turned it off, and then I had mine written on
it. Yeah. So there, so they just like,
okay. Like the appeal. Yeah, and then the art project, the art project thing, like, so cool.
This is your box to our extraordinary daily precious metals update. On Friday, gold is down $1, $1,231 per ounce. Silver is even at $15.03 per ounce. As of the end of the quarter, Robert's is your source for physical precious metals since 1995.
No worries, we'll play it. It's gonna be soon. Just this material, I'll just put it here on the table.
Am I sitting here?
Yes, you're sitting here. Just don't try to box.
No, it's all you.
It's not all me. You are one of the hosts of the show. Thanks for being on. Yeah, well, thank you for having me. We got some smoke later tonight.
Sure.
What's that?
We got smoke later tonight. For sure.
Well,
I don't know.
Should get ready for makeup stuff.
Yeah,
makeup.
Really? Oh, yeah.
What did you do? Do a wireless
we currently asked you guys to eat dinner like I know, but I know. I don't really want to eat out. No, we don't have that much leftovers.
The next
I have more time. The rice. Well, yeah, the rice, but not the food itself. I ate most of it.
Anyway,
I got leftover
Indian
food.
Wow. Okay. But it's repaired so well. Really, yeah, to be the yeah. And you get to see how chicks go to bands.
Man, I only want to go to ISFS because we're missed by a girl we met once.
Yeah, I didn't want to go. It's just. Time is money, you know, it's not in the budget.
If I were going to Florida next week,
you're going to Florida next week?
I told you that, like, a million times. Yeah.
Did you?
The show is going to be...
Yes!
A million?
The show's going to be playing Sydney's for, like, 4 fucking weeks, like, probably barely a month.
Really?
Cody's going to be gone, I'm going to be gone. I doubt Cody will pick up and do it himself while I'm gone.
Why no? So why is it gonna be gone? So why is it not gonna be off the air for so long?
Because I'm gonna be in Florida for 2 weeks.
Okay.
It might just be 3 weeks. I'm gonna be coming back Friday, but I'm gonna be 2 days to do the show. I'm gonna be back
Okay. Okay.
So you guys want to pick up another Friday night slot for a couple weeks more than one? Yes. I wasn't saying most of my show. I was saying if you guys are fucking bored on Friday night, you want to do the wrong
one. Pretty enough as it is. I hate that time slot. I hate the Friday night time slot.
I
guess not. I
don't know. It doesn't bother me too much because I don't really start partying until like midnight anyways. So.
That's true, but I work like most Saturdays. I know you don't really work. Like I really don't know how you even get through it.
Don't be a hater,
Rob. I'm not hating. I ain't hate.
I got a huge door to small.
Yeah, what? I was trying to be funny.
Oh, skip Monday. Yeah.
Oh, let's take a good picture. Come on, yes, let's take a good picture.
Yeah, take a picture with that one.
Yes,
behind.
Oh, no.
Are you ready, Renee?
In an unsettling video released over the web this week, Buddhist extremist self Kalathana about to unleash a massive wave of serenity in our
country. Can I show you how to use it?
Yes.
All you gotta do is press this button right there.
Yeah, I know.
So I assure you, as leaders of the group's absolute commitment to involving Americans in complete and unyielding independence, here now is this video. We will not cease
until every city. Oh, let's talk about Rob. We don't need any more pictures. Let's talk about Rob.
Sources confirm that the Pentagon was surprised in the film by ordering an attack on a woman. The inventor of the Gromdar says he's determined to put a Gromdar
in. Hold it down. Just hold that down until it
clicks. For how long?
Until it clicks.
Yeah, Christopher.
Come on.
When I got here, I was
All right, we're going. Come on, come on. We're back on here. You want to bring it back? Yes, I think it doesn't matter. Go ahead.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We're just getting busy taking selfies because it's Liberty Forum 2016. And now we have two very special guests. We got Ellen Baum.
Hello.
And the lovely Christopher Davis.
Lovely.
Yeah, has anyone ever called you lovely before? No. In the first? It's a lovely. Christopher Davis.
Well, he does have the beard game going on. So we're recently trimmed.
Well, me too. I trimmed about an inch off all the way around it. So it was almost the size of Tony Jankowski's beard, but I brought it down a little bit. Maybe one day I'll get up there, but you gotta trim it and bring it back, you know.
It was not the size of Tony Jankowski's beard. So what's the goal of the beard? Is it just an aesthetic thing? Does it keep your face warm when it's cold outside?
Ellen is so anti beard. No, she likes men who looks like babies.
Some beards look good. Short beards look good.
You don't like my long beard?
When beards get to a certain length,
not really
like
good.
It means that they have a ball sack. And I feel like that's very important to know.
See, like, you have a decent length beard.
No, that's
he's trying to
I feel a little insecure about the length of my beard. I'm going for Gandalf.
Yeah. Why is it all about size?
It's all about size. Size matters. Size just matters.
Well, on top of that, like, women can do so much with the, like, styling and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's
you know,
true.
This is really something you can't do. I think it's male jealousy. We're able to, like, do whatever we can with our face. We can have style. We can be completely different. My beard looks completely different from a lot of other people's beards. I have, a style what I'm going for. You know what?
I like
how
people
pull
style
it off.
The mustache. Like, the curly
mustache.
She
is in me.
Okay, guys, so... How has your Liberty Forum been so far? I've been doing something every goddamn day. But so have you, Ellen. So I feel like me and you are on the same level of exhaustedness.
Well, I've been staying busy, staying at the foundation for New Hampshire Independence table, talking to a bunch of people, having them talk to me. And I've learned a lot, and it's been fun. I've also been spending a lot of time up here, I guess.
That's true, yeah.
Any orgies yet?
Not yet. Maybe for tonight. You're not invited, Renee.
What about you? I've seen your Armpit City.
Yeah, booth down.
Very busy, lots of passerbys interested.
Yeah, I'm kind of floating between the booth and a couple talks and getting talks and going back to my room and huddling and doing computer things. So never done one.
Yeah, you seem to always be working. You're always on the clock.
Chris, you know you need to party with us. It's Liberty Forum. Come on.
Okay.
Yeah, tonight we're gonna get fucked. Mark my words, Liberty Forum. Okay, so as far as Arcade City going, like, I feel like every time I talk to you, there's some new milestone that has been met, so.
Yeah, I mean, we just signed up another 1,000 drivers in the past 72 hours. It just keeps growing faster, so we're just rapidly building out a leadership team, talking with potential investors, like, it's really, really taking off.
So what's the scope of this project?
In the short term, we're out to destroy Uber. In the long term, we're out to destroy governments. Okay, that's the super short version of it. But we want to build a distributed, decentralized logistics network on the blockchain. Similar concept to what people have been talking about in terms of, your more, potentially off-the-grid kind of marketplaces, but focusing on logistics and in-person dealings where you really need to take care about the reputation system. Decentralized reputation is like a huge problem that we want to help solve. So down the road, we want this to be like a marketplace for really any kind of transaction that people want to make that requires person-to-person interaction. And we're starting with ride sharing because that's kind of just grew out of the Free Uber campaign in Portsmouth and our core group. From Free Uber is now kind of doing Arcade City, and there's a huge opportunity now. Part of why we got the huge amount of drivers is because Uber and Lyft just cut their rates across the board early January. So you have drivers everywhere pissed off, protesting in the streets, like really angry. And so now there's a couple different companies trying to become the alternative to Uber, be a little bit more friendly to drivers. And we are the only one of those alternatives that's actually decentralized. One of them is launched only in New York City. We're active in 60 cities because we have people just self-organizing all over the country.
That's beautiful, man. It's beautiful that you're getting that up and running so fast. Like, there's literally, like, it's overnight that, like, you have this going on. You have to be excited and ecstatic about everything with that. You know, especially you're not dealing with politics anymore. You're actually building a business. That's so much better. That's like, the best activism you can do is just, like, do your own thing.
Yeah, we were talking about politics last night and how it changes people. And you guys were talking about the foundation table. And I was there for like 2 seconds and I learned something. Never ask politicians to take a picture with your Foundation for New Hampshire Independence bumper stickers. Because once you go into politics, I swear, it's as MBG said, it's like going into the Klan and you gotta infiltrate, you gotta do things, you can make your Klan members happy. And I mean, I just feel like politics is just a shithole at this point. So, good thing you decided to start a business instead.
Well, and I'm especially excited about the whole independence effort because, you know, I think that that is the logical successor to the Free State Project. I mean, yeah, there's a big focus now on movers, but, you know, let's create more and more of an independent society. And I think that one of the next conversations that the movement needs to have is to what extent are we focusing on a political separation and convincing the State House to declare independence and what's the value of that versus can we build up some adverse infrastructure right now? I mean, you know, just the conversations I've had, you know, yesterday with Virgil talking about, you know, Self-411 and we're going to integrate ride sharing into the Self-411 where you can actually like hail apps and stuff up. But like, yeah, replacing or creating alternatives to emergency services and the kind of things that people are right now like, well, who will do this? If we can have a successful example and say, we actually are beating 911 with the response time right now. Let's scale this up a little bit.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, absolutely. I know one of the biggest questions that the foundation gets is, do you think that we're prepared, New Hampshire is prepared for that sort of separation? Will we be able to supply everyone's needs, economically speaking? And this is just another example that we're definitely ready. I mean, these businesses are springing up all the time and they're so creative and ingenious, really. Like, they're fulfilling every need that people didn't even know that they had.
Well, like, plus with, like, New Hampshire. New Hampshire has an international border. It has a seaport. We're a donor state. The feds take more money than what we actually get back. And then the money that they give back is always with stipulations and strings attached and stuff like that. But going back to like the yesterday in the table, I talked about analysts and how I go to politicians. I know there's I recognize the state reps walking around the vendor area. So I'm like, you know what? The Liberty guy in me is like, all right, I know they support this. I know that they support New Hampshire independence. But like, all right, I'm operating as like the foundation. I'm like, I want to get some photos for the Facebook page. Go like us on Facebook, Foundation for New Hampshire Independence. And I want to get some photos of like state reps that support New Hampshire independence and Liberty Forum. I did get two. Well, one former and one current state rep to hold it up, which I couldn't even believe I got that many to actually do it. But it was fascinating. I don't want to say who it was, so I'm not going to like name names on the air.
You'll just see it on Facebook.
Well, no. The couple reps that declined the offer. I was polite with them. Who accepted?
Yeah.
Well, he had a face as if like he was confused by it. All right. So maybe it's not an endorsement of New Hampshire independence. But Michael Sylvia. Mind you, he's up at the State House smoking a joint during the 420 rally as well. So it's like he's not avoiding controversy as a state rep though. But yeah, he was the one that took the photo, which was he's got balls to do so as a politician.
Well, you know, some of those state reps that you were asking, they're just protecting their personality because they're not selling a product; they're selling themselves.
But they join the state house to, you know, fight for liberty. I don't get it. Like, I understand they might want to protect their reputation and their public image, but first of all, I just feel like if there are state reps who would run, like, on an independent platform, for instance, Mark Warden, he's still a reputable member of the community. He stands his ground. He doesn't, like, trade in his beliefs to fit in. And neither should you, state reps. I look down on you.
So speaking of politics, I just have a question for you. Okay. I'll ask him when we come back from break.
What? I didn't hear it. Besides, gotta have a
Trailbridge was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road underground market.
I know
the
we have
Silk Road
a,
was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug.
Ian has to have a cable somewhere.
Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your
support. I have no idea.
Please visit freeross.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit freeross.org. That's freeross.org.
This is a national health care alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You can qualify for a pain-related knee brace at a lower cost.
Yeah, it's like the hot box.
And all the paperwork
but today is like a truck.
Yeah.
Today is like 80 degrees. Oh no, if yesterday was 80, today is like 105.
I am around here for problems like shoulders
and
computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office prop, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.lrn.fm. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit the Liberty Radio Network.
What is on Amazon? There's a, after the awards dinner, which I ain't going
looking for an excuse.
There is a dance party in the salon.
Yeah,
right
salon
after salon A, right after.
And is it Leslie's Nixon?
That's at 8 o'clock. And all that cool. She's doing a
yeah, and then there's
various forms of activism. What season?
That's at 8, but I'm more looking forward to the dance party at 10.
And learn about making a move.
So,
Dance Party 10.
No, 10. The
Dance Party Salon A is at 10.
Yeah,
Leslie's
that's around 10:30-ish.
She
has, yeah, in all text, the all text mode on.
She's there making a dating app. Well, they made an app. A dating app for Liberty.
Credit card or Bitcoin.
Oh, is that the,
only 100 pre-order tickets are available. So reserve your tickets now.
No,
liberty.info. Visit keenvention.info for more. Or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Did you know you can listen to LRN.FM via our free-to-air
no,
satellite
channels?
Check out
the app.
We have channels over nearly all of North America and much of Africa. All you need is an affordable receiver and dish as well as
no, it's going to be a
software. I don't know
no how... It's going to be a software.
That's a problem? In regards to, like, here... No, I'm saying in regards to, like, women. There's so many women here. Like, yeah, this room is literally 50-50 split. I don't know, man. My circles I'm in, there's majority. There's at least 50% or 40% women. Like, I don't know. I don't understand this.
There needs to be an app that's optimized for environments where it's like 10-1 male.
There needs
just
to
be email all the power and then just.
I guess you can say that.
No, there needs to be a seminar on how to not be fucking creepy.
How not to be a creeper chair.
Yeah, and then maybe the men.
Everyone uses Facebook. Few people are signing up for the Shire
what
Society.
What do you mean by giving
rid
of
so drop in and say
because I think that would be scary.
Shire Society.
Have you read,
yeah,
I've
heard
about
it.
It's fascinating. It's one of their books. Like, I got it because the cover says, the book off the I'll tell you.
Want to bring
it
back?
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show live at Liberty Forum. We're here with Christopher David and Ellen Ball. We're talking about something on race, and we're gonna
dating sites, apparently.
I had a question.
Oh, Ellen had a question. Oh, that was a cliffhanger. Okay, go for it, Ellen.
All right, so we can all feel this relief. Christopher, in regards to legislation, what is the biggest barrier that you have to overcome with RKCity, or is there any?
So we're paying close attention to the ride-sharing bill that's going through the State House now, which is based on quote-unquote Uber model legislation, which means that they wrote the bill. So this is the bill that Uber's been getting, like, kind of ran through legislatures all over the country. They just had the same bill passed up in Maine. They're trying to get this passed now in New Hampshire. But one of the big problems is they've written into this a mandatory minimum of insurance coverage for $1 million. The market standard is $300,000. Every taxi, like all the municipalities around New Hampshire, when they regulate insurance, they set a mandatory minimum of $300K. One city, Hampton, a year and a half ago, tried to raise that to $1 million. It caused all these problems. The taxis couldn't afford it. They had to pull out, all this legal mess. So basically, by allowing Uber to write this into law, where that's now the minimum for the entire state, it's going to require, it screws the smaller competitor who doesn't have a $10 billion budget out of competing. So this bill, as it's written currently, would basically hand the TNC market to Uber. We're kind of, you know, in kind of like a last-minute lobbying effort. I mean, they've been writing this bill for the past year, assuming that Uber is the only relevant entity, and if some other entity emerges, that we'll have our own army of lobbyists and participate in that process. So we're having some progress. The bill sponsor is at least open to the idea of reducing it from $1,300,000, which there's still some other problems that will at least make it manageable. But let's say this goes through and we can't afford or don't want to register as a TNC in the state of New Hampshire, we have a couple ways around that. One is having drivers individually register their vehicles as commercial plates. My main right-hand guy with Free Uber, Dennis Acton, is our COO. He just got his vehicle. He's got a nice Mercedes. He just registered it with the state. Got commercial insurance, livery plates, that whole thing. Cost him, a couple grand over the period of the year. But he can add other drivers to that, and it's a little bit different than rideshare, but it's one way to get legal and be fully insured. So that's one tier, kind of what we're calling the arcades, or like the fully insured rides. And then the rebel rides. For example, people in Keene, they're probably not going to care too much about going through hoops and things, and that's completely fine. They can use our platform just to set up communication and handle payment peer-to-peer, and so that's not really going to be relevant to the TNC thing. But if the TNC bill goes through and we like it, then there will be some LLC that goes through that process. But we're kind of attacking from multiple angles, so we don't care really which way things go.
Beautiful. Now, to change some subjects here, during the break, we were talking about the dating situation for libertarians and all that jazz, and apparently there's a dating app coming out to solve that. But you're saying how it's like 10-1 male to female. You really believe that?
I don't think
liberty movement.
That's a slight exaggeration. I'm not the authority on this. Ask your female co-host here what their perception
is. Is that the case?
I think that it could be even, but there are men who don't know how to socialize here, and there are women who don't know how to socialize here as well. So I feel like maybe to solve this love and liberty problem, we need some kind of seminars to teach people, how to interact and, like normal and not creepy.
Okay,
I feel like there's a
libertarian
problem.
Completely unrealistic, to be honest.
No, okay, let me say what is normal.
It's
okay,
unrealistic to try and change people's personality.
Yeah, no, it's not their personality that's the problem. I mean, normal, as in sometimes when you have conversations with people who are socially awkward because they don't know how to interact with people, that it trails off. Like, if two socially awkward people are having a conversation and neither of them know how to talk to each other, maybe they need a seminar, maybe they need a book, maybe they need someone to kind of help them bridge that gap. Because you're never going to get anywhere if you just have a bunch of awkward people in a room and everyone's looking away and no one's talking to each other. So I feel like that is more of the dating problem.
See, I don't think that's as much of an educational failure as maybe they don't have that confidence.
Yeah, but
maybe
I feel like
going through some sort of mental struggle of their own.
Everyone doesn't have a mental
struggle
of
their own time.
Some people just need help in that area. And I've met a lot of people who aren't ashamed to say, like, yeah, maybe it would be nice if we had some kind of like dating seminar, like how to approach women. How do we like flirt in a way that isn't, demeaning or creepy? How do you there's been a lot of like instances where maybe Rob says it all the time, he just doesn't know how to talk to women. So he's writing LR on Facebook saying, hey, I like your feet from across the street. So maybe someone needs to say, what kind of things are appropriate and what isn't appropriate. I feel like a dating app
is a good idea, but I feel like maybe we need some more social interaction courses in Liberty, and maybe get more people to meet, because there are a lot of single women, and I've tried to hook a lot of them up, and it's really hard sometimes because of that like social awkwardness that lags between people. But that's just what I think. I think there could be enough women for men, but we gotta fix those social awkwardness first.
Well, if people are socially awkward and they're talking to you about it, then clearly they're like reaching out and they feel comfortable enough with you to tell you about that. So maybe they just need to become more comfortable with people and spend more time out in public, and that would help solve most of the problem.
Probably, but my thing is, like, I understand that there's a lot more men in the movement than there are women, but here in the Shire, it's at least 30 to 40% women. From my look at this room. There's more women in this room than there are men right now.
But this is a very small room.
Well, this is a very small movement. I mean, from my perspective, yeah, like, I don't know what this, you know, thing is. It's only all men. Like, so many people here in this movement in New Hampshire and FSP is like, there's a lot of women that are taking active roles, leading roles, and getting shit done. And it's not just a male-dominated thing. Maybe in other parts of the country it is, but definitely not here. In regards to, like, relationship-wise, yeah, women, there's obviously there's a higher market value for the simple fact that there's more men than there are women. But, you know, there's also this whole, like, I don't know if, like, people try to date in the community or in the movement and stuff like that. I understand that you want to have a like-minded person to be with. I get that. I 100% get that. But at the same time, you shouldn't focus on I'm only going to be with this person because they're a libertarian or an anarchist or something like that. You know, that's ridiculous. Like, there's so many people in the world that you can, like, reach out to. Like, don't, like, you know, hold yourself back.
So that's funny that you made that comment, because there was this like viral Facebook post. This guy was like, "Don't date women in the liberty movement. Like, don't do it. Don't talk to them. Don't even step forward. Just venture out. Like, don't do it." And I wanted to know what his point was, and I still don't really get it. I mean, I feel like dating outside of the liberty movement could be good, because you can bring someone in. But yeah, like I was interested in through Bob's business. Yeah, that's what happened. Anyway, I feel like dating. Yeah, exactly. I feel like dating outside is good for that reason. But I also feel like it's kind of a cesspool sometimes, and we're all poly sisters and brothers. Everyone at this table, we're all in one big poly family. Happy, I'm just kidding. Eskimo sisters for life, yo. Woo!
All right, thank you, Chris, for being on.
Thank you.
I appreciate it so much. Very much appreciate it.
I like
FDP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom.
Oh, Tatiana, I got a...
We're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are. And like I said, a lot of.
Oh, it was on the whole hour, Bobby?
For sure. If you can off, you can. I'd like to have this.
Well, it's called. Okay. No, I wish you could just be here. I didn't even care about myself. Oh, well, that's fine. We'll share. But you know there's.
Oh,
no, it's fine. We can just share.
I know, but it's like only four.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk.
We have a phone charger.
What? I forgot the name.
Here's a chance to do a little activism like cruising Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus.
This is what I'm wearing, and this is my guy.
Yeah, that's you. Test, test, 1, 2, 1, 2. Can you strum a little bit?
Like a comment.
Is it coming through?
If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of Liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can
I'm not hearing it coming through.
It takes to click on something at facebook.freetalklive.com.
Here, let me try something else. How's that?
There we go.
Change your life.
That's better.
This is one such time. You can save up to an hour 25% on your day purchase of Amazon. But now you can get a 25% discount on nearly every app you need as a Lyft. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim.
And if you want to just dump every picture I've taken, do this right now.
Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new
item.
This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to SaveItFirst.com right now, get signed up, and cash in the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through SaveItFirst.com. It's SaveItFirst.com.
I'm going to blog on your demands for being a shitty photographer.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can now discover our satellite costs with a chip in on the right side of the page at
lrn.com. Alright, we're coming back.
My mom's still everything.
Alright. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show here live at Liberty Forum in Manchester, New Hampshire. And now we have our third time probably at this point. But anyways, Tatiana Morrow's first time on the Rebel Love Show.
Welcome.
Thank you for coming
Very
on.
Very happy to be here.
Yeah, I met you last night.
Who would have thought, from a jacuzzi to the Rebel Love Show?
I know.
That happens more often than not, believe it or not.
Jacuzzi. I didn't know who you were or what you're doing. I still don't, actually. We're just jacuzzi buddies at this point. So can you tell me a little about yourself? How you got involved, how long have you lived in with men, all that good stuff?
Sure. So I grew up always knowing that I wanted to sing, but at the same time, my mom trained me well, and she was playing a lot of music from the 60s and the 70s, which made me realize how powerful music could be to bring about change. I didn't really figure out exactly how that was going to fit together, though, until about 2011. I'd been politically active before then, supporting Dennis Kucinich, but in 2011, when I found out about the Federal Reserve, that's when I got involved with the Ron Paul movement, and I sort of found my community, and I started writing music that reflected that newfound philosophy, and I was welcomed very warmly, and then since then, I've played all over the country, all over the world, not only just for Ron Paul stuff, but then kind of moving into the Bitcoin space, where I created the first ever artist cryptocurrency, Tatiana Coin. And I'm scaling that idea now so other artists can make their own cryptocurrencies and create their own ecosystems with their fans.
That's awesome. Well, I'm looking forward to hearing you sing.
Yeah,
so what?
Never heard you sing before. Well, I'm excited to sing. I've been having some vocal problems for a couple of years, so it's still a little bit rough. But, you know, I just got out of Lynn Ulbricht's talk here at Liberty Forum. And I actually had a chance to see her speak many times. We toured around Poland together, we were in Prague together. And, you know, every single time it really sinks in what a crazy and awful story that is. And I think it's really important that people can understand that. So the song that I'm going to sing today is called The Silk Road, and I wrote it about, you know, mostly actually influenced by Lynn's telling of what happened there, and of course, subsequently getting to know Ross, it seemed a little bit more apropos, but the goal was to sort of humanize this experience for people. And even though, you know, he's a drug kingpin and going to the news and a murderer, we all know here in this room that that's not true. And the goal of music is to educate people. So that's kind of the impetus for the song.
Well, he's a hero to us.
Yeah,
sure.
he's definitely a hero to us. And as we were talking about last night, like, it's one of the saddest stories. And when the revolution happens, that's the first place we're going to get him right out.
And I also want to add, I'm really supportive of what you're doing with music. I think music has always been and will always be, you know, the best way to communicate a story to people in a way that they relate to and can easily memorize and actually feel the emotions of it in a more human way. So thank you for, you know, writing a song about something like this.
Well, I like doing that. I think it's, you know, it gives me just as much as it, I think, hopefully gives to the audience. And it really gives me a sense of purpose. So I'm happy to do it, and I'm happy to be appreciated for it, so thank you.
Well, if you don't want to, we'll want to now. Let's hear this song.
Sure, we've got time, right?
Yeah, you got time. The mic is yours.
Okay. How's it? Is it coming through the guitar?
Just go for it.
I'm not hearing it come through. Well, wait, let's see if we can fix that.
Okay. Well, we're on live radio, so.
Okay.
There you go. That works.
Okay. Well, then I'll turn it off with here, because otherwise it's going to be like loud and weird.
No worries.
There was a man who did the unspoken. He looked at freedom from the violence. No one is perfect when there's new ground broken. A mess is made and someone gets blamed. He had a dream of harmony as he wished to live out your own. We cannot stand for the skin that had you fall along the Silk Road. This ain't the movies, there's a war in the streets. The innocent are in jail. He prayed for justice and he wanna be free and hope the truth will prevail. He had a dream of harmony as you wish to live out your own. We cannot stand for the skin that had you fall along the Silk Road. We can't give up, we cannot quit. Don't be afraid. We have a voice, and this is it. Let the light show the way. Dream of harmony as you wish to live out your throne. We cannot stand for the skin that have you fall along the Silk Road. We cannot stand for the skin that have you fall along.
Thank you. You're so beautiful.
Oh, thanks, guys. You know, we were talking about art and liberty and, you know, how important those things are. And one of the really cool things that Lynn is announcing over the weekend, which was sort of Ross's idea, was he made this really beautiful art piece. And it was, well, I've heard it's beautiful, I'm assuming it. And so he did the trial I saw. So what he saw from, you know, his position, and he did it, you know, just with pencil, because that's all he gets in jail, right? And in order to raise money for the appeal and everything like that, it's extremely expensive. So what they're doing is this really fun game. You go to art.freeross.org. Oh, if you go to freeross.org, and you can basically see it. And it came to Ross in a dream where when people would donate, little pixels would kind of come off of it. So people already started donating, and they're making kind of shapes. So they made a heart and then Bitcoin and a free Ross and stuff like that. So I think that's a really innovative use of technology and art and messaging. And, you know, I just think it's a really good way to kind of raise awareness and maybe touch people a little bit differently than just the mainstream news or something like that.
Absolutely. It's not even Ross's artwork that is hidden there. It's also other people who are trying to help out, and they're creating artwork of their own on top of it. So that is very interesting.
Well, on top of that, like, so many people, like, when we try to get the word out, like, there's not enough art to go behind it. So like with music and what you're talking about, like it definitely portrays that message that you don't see with, like, you know, we need to reach out to more and more people as possible, and art's definitely a way, like with music and everything else. And that's not something that happens. I mean, we're just doing a podcast radio show. That's just like we're talking, but like seeing actual, like, you know, artists do things to portray the message, I'm always in favor of seeing more and more of that happening.
Definitely. I consider myself an artist. I feel like this project is full of artists, and as long as we just keep spreading the word for your beautiful music and voice, I'm so happy I got to meet you.
This is really
now
beautiful.
You
just
developed a groupie.
Oh, I
like
that. Well, okay. after the hot tub.
My website is TatianaMorose.com, and if people want to participate with the Free Ross Project, just go to freeross.org. And I've got a show coming out on LRN. It's the Tatiana Show and albums and all sorts of stuff. So, okay,
awesome.
We talked to the door. Actually, can we get up for a second sound?
What?
Second
sound? Actually, well, then would you want to be on for one segment? Yeah, that's
awesome. That would be
it is our last segment.
Yeah, I think that
would
be good.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we're on with Lynn.
Yeah, if you want to be up together.
Wait, why don't you? Yeah, okay, cool. Let me just put down my guitar because I'm all sweaty. I'm like, this thing is bulky.
Thanks for being on, Ellen. I'm going to be.
Now it works, right?
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm gonna be down at the table probably. What time is it? 4:00. I'll probably be down there from like 4:30 to 6:30, something like that.
Really? I thought we were going to see the tennis.
Yeah, I told them.
Is that 4?
Yeah, I told them.
Okay.
So,
yeah, Mateus is talking about 4. I just said 4. Yeah, so I still want to go see Mateus. Yeah.
Oh, Lynn, I think you're going to
show it here.
Yes, I see some sort
so
of
what are your name?
I am Rob. I'm Matthias. This is the Rebel Love Show. We do a once a week broadcast. This is also live. This is also live on LMN right now. This is a weekly broadcast as well. It's also going to be on YouTube as well. And it's a podcast. So there's video, there's audio, and it's live.
You can wave to the camera. Oh, yeah.
The love show is spreading love.
That's usually what we do.
This is Charlie Sumser with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your.
If we come back in about 2 minutes.
Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have assistance.
Yeah. She has to wear that vest in order to be
in the room.
She has to wear that. Yeah, she wouldn't be allowed in there if she wasn't a quote unquote a service dog.
I thought she really
did. Yeah, she's pretty much on airplanes.
Yep.
Yeah, one of those.
Yeah, you can order it off Amazon.
In this specific
room, because they're
like survey or something like that. Some was weird. Yeah.
Yeah, she's on my lap on the airplane. Just make sure they're able to be around people, otherwise the dog are all the way parking and meeting people.
Just because it
helps
style
arrangement. Yeah, no, like, I can't stop. Exactly. You're like, just
the stars. You should link on your social media. And let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.FM. Download it now free at apps.lrn.fm.
I fucking hate my app.
Why do you hate your app?
Yeah.
On Friday, it was $7.
But you have good, you have a good radio voice.
My voice sounds better.
Mine sounds worse. I think my voice sounds worse in recording than actually Peter promises. We should
probably talk. Oh, I'm a voice actor.
The smooth baritone voice of Robin Miles.
Yeah. I just do
both, so
I don't
think.
Make sure you can work
the MRN.FM.
I'll
take you again. Well, no, we're coming back in like 10 seconds.
Oh, yeah,
yeah, on my decal. Yeah, we know life, you know life, you know life, you know life, you know life.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. This is the last segment of our live broadcast from Liberty Forum here in Manchester, New Hampshire, for the Free State Project.
And we got a special guest to close the show. I feel so honored here because I'm really sad we had to miss your speech. That was one I really wanted to go to. So
we got Lynn Albrecht here, mother of Ross Albrecht. It's a pleasure to have you on. Ross, to both of us, is a hero. And I know you had a talk here earlier during our broadcast earlier. What did you come to Liberty Forum to talk about?
Let me just say first that this song that Tatiana's written, every time I hear it, I get chills and cry. It's so beautiful, and so appreciate all her support and all her creativity. And she's like my PR advisor. She plays many roles in my life, so I really appreciate it. I need a lot of help. but I came here to talk about the appeal. Ross was sentenced to Devil Life without parole for all nonviolent charges, first-time offender. Pretty outrageous, way off the out of ballpark, really, of a normal sentencing. And the appeal was filed last month, and it's 2.5 times longer than average. Had to get special permission, and the lawyer said they could have put a whole lot more in. That's how many violations in the trial there were. And it's a powerful document. It really is protecting not only, or defending, not only Ross and his due process rights, but all of our rights. Because, you know, if one person doesn't have a fair trial, that erodes the protections from us all.
Yeah.
Well, so go ahead.
I know one way to help, obviously, is financially, and we can go for free Ross. So I wanted to ask, like, activism-wise, because I'm the type of activist, like, I like to go places. Like, I would like to go stand outside of his trial and protest. But I know that there was some bad media about the last time people went out there. So do you think that would be a beneficial way to kind of help and just show, like, our disapproval, like, you know, make signs, come out there, stand, and actually do, like, the upfront activism? Or is it just better to kind of, you know, be behind the scenes and, you know, help any other way?
Yeah, let me just clarify some things about what happened. We loved having people come and hand out jury information pamphlets and to stand up and express their First Amendment rights outside the courthouse. What happened was, after the first day of trial, the judge threatened to sequester the jury because of it. Those people were gone. And that would prejudice the jury because mostly they sequester defendants who are a threat to them. It's a protective action for the jury. You know, mob bosses, those kind of people. And the lawyer just felt it was too big a risk to have her sequester the jury. Now, the good thing is, and these people went home, I hated doing that. But the good thing is that before they left, there were enough media there that put pictures of them made into the Drudge Report, in fact, all over the internet. So, didn't work out for the judge that way.
Yeah.
Now, as far as doing it again, there's not even going to be a hearing for probably at least a year. I'd have to ask the lawyers their opinion.
Okay.
I don't know that appellate judges, if that would be a good thing or a bad thing, to be honest. I don't know.
Okay.
In the meantime, please spread the word, please, you know, on social media, everything else, because it's really, really what I wanted to focus on in my talk today. There's big issues at stake here. It's not, you know, drugs, blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to minimize that, but it's been totally sensationalized. The media, the prosecution has used uncharged allegations like murder for hire, all this kind of sensationalistic stuff. But there's huge issues for us all in this case, and I did highlight a few. You know, we're dealing with, we're at the crossroads here in history.
Yeah, I mean, this case was a huge example of the federal government going way overboard, like showing their force, and doing what they want to do, when all he was doing is operating a website on an open free market.
Yeah, there's a guy sitting in prison for the rest of his life for running a website,
but that's why they did that. I believe it was a political threat. I don't think it had a thing to do with drugs, because they don't send drug dealers just like that.
Yeah, a normal drug dealer, they might get, it's sad that even drug dealers get busted, but they're not serving the time.
People should be more outraged, and people are outraged. So, I mean, any way that we can help, even if it is just continuing to talk about it, no one should forget him. No one should forget that he's sitting in there for no reason.
That's right.
So, what's the latest on it? You said there's a possible, another court date, appeal.
That you have to raise money for?
Well, it's constant. I mentioned in the talk, and this wasn't the lawyers, this is a whole other guy. We got to go for over $13,000 just to assemble the books and the appeal in a book, and then the digital appeals for the appellate court. It's over $13,000. Who can do this?
And then
lawyers, and they put a ton of work into that appeal. I was thrilled with the appeal. It was excellent, but it's a lot of hours, a lot of billable hours.
Yeah.
And it's beyond the scope of any normal, regular person, and that's who we are. We're not, bazillionaires.
Yeah, I mean, most people aren't. I hope you guys get a lot of donations just for lawyer fees to get everything going, because we do want them out.
And I'm seeing more and more of this kind of thing with, the courts overreaching, the police setting people up. I think now more than ever, people need to donate to this cause, because we need to see some justice, because none has been shown in this case.
How has his mentality been behind? Like, I can say you guys have normal
conversations. Can't
you
write letters and stuff?
How's he holding up?
He's an amazing guy. Tatiana's visited with him, and I visit with him, his aunt does, as much as we can. I make sure he's a visitor every week, because it's so important. Ross is a very, I'm inspired by how he's handling this. He intentionally stays positive. He intentionally is a productive contribution to the other inmates. He's very well educated. He's taught classes and all kinds of things. And he just, he's just intentionally not getting too discouraged and depressed. It's easy to do.
That's good. Don't let the man get him down.
I don't know how he does that. I couldn't do it. He's definitely a strong individual.
Yes. And it's very, yes.
I know you write letters frequently to him, so that's good. I hope he's getting a lot of influx. I don't know how he feels about it, but I want to write a letter.
Sure.
I know he doesn't know me, though. So.
It's nice for him. It doesn't matter. A lot of people don't know him, right? And it's good for him to know he's not alone. You're saying it's very easy to forget people once they're in prison. And he can't even use email because it's an internet crime. And
he can't even email from prison?
Inmates do, because it's an internet crime.
Wow.
And it's weird, because they could monitor his emails. I mean, I don't think they want to. But anyway,
It's not about that. It's about control for them. And that's all this situation is. So, we're going to keep talking about it. I do want to write him a letter. I want to keep him alive. And, as long as we have shows like this and conventions like this, his memory will always be kept alive. There's at least 20,000 people who are going to just let this go down. Quietly.
It'd be a lot of fun to get him out.
Speaking of that, I'm surprised by this, the amount of support from like people who were part of the Free State Project.
Well, I really started my quote-unquote public speaking career at Porfest. And that was not this past one, but the one before. So I consider the Free State Project like family. You know, they, Carla and everyone has been really so supportive. And coming back, I just feel like, ah, support, love, it's great. You know, and I tell Ross, and you know, he was calling last night, and I was telling him about it. And it just, it's so encouraging to us, because most of the time I'm sitting on a computer, you know, and we get hate mail, we get all this stuff, and it's just so good to know that people.
Well, I'm happy that the Free State Project can be that outlet for you, and if you ever need our help or support or anything, you know, Rob will give you his business card here, and we're very happy. We do want to be involved, and I'm really happy you came on the show. So,
yeah,
can you
thank
wrap
you.
It up, telling us any last, like, where can we go donate, where can we send Ross these letters, you know, anyway.
Yeah, well, freeross.org is pretty much the source of all info, and if you email, you'll probably get me. And, there's a contact page with his new address. He was just moved 2 days ago. It's in Brooklyn. And so just go to freeross.org. You can contact me, you can contact him.
Well, yeah. Hopefully one day.
You can donate.
Hopefully one day soon.
Play a game.
When he does win his appeal and he gets released from jail. Hopefully that happens like right before Porkfest.
Yeah.
And that Porkfest would be like the celebration of Ross being free.
Ross,
I would love to see something like that. Like hopefully it times just perfectly so like he gets released like right at a Porkfest or something like that. So all of us,
yeah,
you know, will be there. I mean, everyone in FSB, everyone in this community loves Ross.
Yeah.
I mean, we all want to see him free. It's like, it, you know, it's a crime that he's in there. It just shows what the federal government will do. And our heart goes out to him.
Our heart goes out to him.
Thank
you
so much.
And
yeah.
Where can we find you, Tatiana?
TatianaRose.com.
And the Tatiana Show coming out soon?
Yeah.
On LRN.FL, no less.
Yeah. It's been a great episode of the Rebel Love Show. We love you guys.
Rebel Show.com. Life and Liberty Forum. Peace, guys.